You'd have been in this game for a long time.
My game, I've been in this game long. You know the first person I opened up for?
Who?
Take a guess. First person
Richard
I opened
Pryor.
Up for. No. Boom, boom, boom. Boom.
Bill Cosby?
Boom, boom, no.
Or a comedian.
A singer.
Prince?
I mean, no. No.
No.
Older than that.
A Barry singer? White?
Yeah.
We name hella old niggas.
Play the piano.
So Malcolm Steve X. Who you on
Ray Charles. Ray Charles.
Ray Charles?
Ray Charles.
Give it up,
at the Richmond, at Charles the Richmond Hall. Auditorium.
In Richmond?
Richmond Auditorium.
That's hard.
At the time. Still got the poster up on the wall. I don't know what year that was.
Hey, man. Hey, Lou.
You opened up for...
Make sure you
that was the first person
to
open up
so
for.
I can see that motherfucker.
I think it was 1988.
87.
No.
Damn.
87.
Ray Charles? That's fucked up. He wasn't able to see you.
That nigga asshole. Hey, no, hey. Hey, niggas said Ray Charles had chunkums being a blind nigga, bro.
Ray Charles turned it out.
They said he had chunkums. Nigga, he was beating niggas up.
Ray Charles.
Off his money, yeah. Nigga, did you see the movie Ray Charles?
Yeah, I seen it. I didn't see him beat nobody up.
He dived on the table on a nigga because the nigga short changed him.
They probably just put that in the movie to make him just as move, make it entertaining.
And you know how Charlie Murphy had the true Hollywood stars with Rick James? Nigga. And say shit with Rick.
See, you heard
Ron,
that
nigga.
From some OG niggas in your hood.
Nah,
Mark
no,
Curry
bro.
Really didn't work with him. How was
nigga,
Ray Charles?
Look, nigga.
He beat me up. Took my money.
No, I'm telling you, nigga, look. When I say no, you know, remember the house you came to on 85th and Norman?
Uh-huh.
Nigga, Rick James' pops stayed on the next block from me, nigga.
Rick James' pops?
Yeah, nigga, just tell
me the
story.
Oh, you saying Rick James or Ray Charles?
No, but I'm saying, I say, you know how like Charlie Murphy had the true Hollywood stories about Rick James, about the shit that he used to do when he used to fight that nigga?
Mark, you know anything about what this nigga talking about?
Well, I'm a little confused right now, Jim.
Okay.
Let's go back in the podcast.
Okay, let's...
We were talking about Rick James or Ray Charles.
We were talking about Ray Charles, Normandy. But I said, you said that it was fucked up that he couldn't see the nigga. I said, nah, but he was whooping niggas' ass being blind.
The drugs have kicked in.
See, look, the niggas in the comments gonna know what I'm talking
about.
Yeah,
put
about.
A comment.
Because Dave Chappelle has some true Hollywood stories that niggas thought this person was this certain way. Like, he was just a wild nigga, but niggas used to really fight.
So how the hell did you open up for Ray Charles?
That's crazy.
You know, I don't even remember.
Because niggas didn't have social media, so you had to just walk up everywhere.
No, somebody, I think I had a booker or something, and they asked me did I want to open up for Ray Charles. And, I said, yeah. I don't, you know, I became a little comedian, you know, just doing, you know, slots.
Yeah.
That's a good question. I don't even know where that booking came from.
Right.
But my father didn't believe me. You know, eating. Dad, I'm about to open up for Ray Charles. I said, well, good luck.
I know your ass better make it to work tomorrow.
Yeah,
that's
yeah.
All you
have fun now. Tell him about that. All right.
What was the worst show you ever done? Like on some like starting off.
Worst show. I remember I did a show at the Beverly Center back in the day, and
at the mall.
Yeah, the Beverly Center. Back in the day, Beverly Center was popping.
Yeah,
the malls was popping at the time.
That's that's Beverly Hills.
Bro. Yeah, for his parents, that was Lifestyles of Rich and Painful. That was they may not even went. That was a trip.
You was performing at the mall.
Well, at the bottom part, they had a club, and that's L.A. was popping. So came to L.A. L.A. was just like it is now. Like
it's the shit. Yeah.
And I remember she paid me a lot of money, and nobody listened. But as the game was real, I knew that money. I said, I ain't going to stop talking. Give me my money. I think they gave me, I don't know,
$600. Oh, that's chicken. That's damn near $6,000 for right
exactly.
Now.
Exactly. We're like, what? She had saw me perform somewhere. That's why it's important.
I'm going out to eat tomorrow.
And she had money, and it was her birthday party. And she said she wanted me. Nobody, I think Jeffrey Osborne performed in front of me. And I tracked him over. And then it was an L.A. crowd. Man, I was a comedian, so it was like, you know, I mean, they were looking at me like I was, but I didn't care less. I got that paycheck. I enjoyed. That's what I learned. I learned the game.
Yeah.
I did shows. I did a show in San Ramon. I never forget this, where it was three people in the place. I was doing comedy, and them two people were kissing the whole time, and one person And I said, fuck, I just kept talking, get my little money. That's when you get like a little $75 a night.
Yeah.
Get your little money, get a little Volkswagen. Be back at paying save in the morning.
Somebody was kissing, you didn't address it?
No, no, they were kissing the whole time, making out while I was doing comedy.
Damn.
You know, I remember that, so. But I always
keep I would have brought one of my bitches up there. I ain't finna be kissing in front of me. I'm finna. Nah,
I learned.